Well, I've been working in forest research for about 30 years, so I started in 95. I've been working in forest research across two centuries, now I'm realizing, okay? And whether I was expecting to see robots in the forest, well, not really.
We developed a technology called simultaneous localization and mapping, which allows robots to carry sensors through environments and build up 3D maps of them. It started in the depths of COVID, so in 2020 we wanted to do a mapping project that was outdoors, and we literally went out to woods here in Oxford and started to do some mapping, and it did snowball into a collaborative project with colleagues across Europe.
Britain is the second largest importer of timber after China in the world, so we really need timber. And we need to ensure that as much as possible is coming from domestic production. But also our forests are very important for many reasons, to preserve the biodiversity, capturing carbon, also for recreation. Trying to maximize their potential is complicated if you don't have a good data set. Forests are not like other features on the ground, like houses or bridges or roads. They keep growing or dying. They are quite dynamic in nature. So the idea is to provide not only a static view at some point in time, but also to a continuous supply of data that can inform you what we're growing and where.
There's a real necessity to be able to get more detailed information by going in amongst the forest, to be able to identify which trees that year are coming up to need intervention or to be chopped down, rather than these very severe practices of clear felling, of knocking down the entire forest. So this extra information is needed to make intelligent decisions about that.
Robots will have the advantage of covering larger areas, being more permanent in the forest, capturing a lot of information.
So a previous approach, you'd really only be able to map a small, maybe 30 by 30 meter plot in a day. In this case, we'd be able to map maybe 5, 6, 7 times as much.
Sometimes you have to work with the precision of a brain surgeon. In some areas, we can go to individual tree level.
We're developing web portals to give forest owners this kind of detailed information. Closing this gap between technology and its deployment to the forestry industry. Oxford is certainly a world-leading research centre in this area, but in a natural environment there's so much unpredictability. Being in an office environment, working on data and writing computer code is one part of what we do, and it's quite intellectually stimulating, but working with a walking robot in a boggy field up to its knees in mud, it just brings different things to a day job. It's different.
Yes, for team is very interesting because they're doing fantastic things, things that I never imagined. And it's a kind of a virtual team that that is working very well.
To break your system and then have the opportunity to make it better is a sort of an intellectual exercise. That's a lot of fun.